It's called Iger Norwand. Okay, well, I got talked into doing something. Jesus, I don't know how I let my friends do that to me. I was never... Oh, look, a part of the scab fell off. That's cool. I was basically totally against VR headsets because everyone that I tried sucked. The screen door effect... Okay, so it started out, I tried... like some of the original Oculus ones. My friend brought it over and I put it on and I was, for the cost that he paid for it, I was literally shocked at how bad it looked. The screen door effect. I mean, I was like, hey, bro, I'm playing on a 75-inch 4K TV and... You think this looks fucking awesome when you put it on? Just because you can move your head and have it move on? You think that that's cool? Listen, shit is shit. I don't care if you can look at it like this or not, okay? Poop is poop. That's it. And so I was pretty assured that it was going to be a while before. And so I basically followed that technology for many years until PlayStation came out with their VR headset, the first one. I tried that headset and it looked like shit. It was also janky and jerky and too much of this in the car, like that, when the road was rough or whatever. And I mean, I'm on the dirt track and it's like this. I could understand why people got sick to their fucking stomachs. Because when you're sitting in a car, your car is suspension and might be moving like this, but your head is dead still. How do I know? Because I've been a professional racer, on road and off road. And I can tell you, your head does not. Okay? Now, on the bikes, when I'm going 200 miles an hour, my head is buffeting around, okay, like this. But... I can associate that motion with my ear and my eyes and the G-forces acting on my body, and therefore it doesn't make me sick. But I can understand why people wearing a VR headset with shit moving like this, but their ears telling them they're sitting still, why they would get sick. Because your fucking eyeball is going to want to be following shit like that, okay? And that will make you sick. Guaranteed. So, let me see. Then my buddy brought over the Meta headset. This is right after the Sony VR headset came out, so it's about three generations back on theirs. And again, it looked like shit. It looked like shit. 1080p split, okay, so you're getting 540 both eyes. It looked like shit. Also, I wear glasses. I have astigmatism. But I have been convinced by someone to purchase the headset and try it. So what I did was, because I'm only getting it for, I had to buy the bundle to get the deal. So I got a very good deal. I got the PSVR 2 headset. I got the Forbidden Horizons, the something mountain, something or other. But I'm getting it for Gran Turismo 7. Okay, period. Yes, I'll probably play the other game. I tried it before. It wasn't immersive enough for me. But maybe it will be with the VR headset. Every experience I had with a headset sucked. It was either uncomfortable, it was hot, it just wasn't. My glasses on the side leaked light really bad. And I mean, it was just not a pleasant experience. If it's not jerky like this, like I'm seeing on these YouTube videos, go watch any VR headset YouTube video, and you're going to see the picture they're showing you is doing this, okay? That's just unfucking playable for me. That's not going to bring a sense of realism to me, because I know how my head reacts in a helmet, in a race car, and on a race bike, and on a stock bike. I mean... I've been doing this since I was like I got my first car when I was 12. I was like 9 when I got my first Cushman. You know what I mean? I mean, I had a 650 BSA that I rode to school in 8th grade. Yes, it had twin compression releases that my mom's boyfriend put on there for me. Different time then, okay? So this is what I did. I ordered it from Amazon so that I could have an easy return if I didn't like it, okay? I'll make sure that if I'm seeing this kind of shit, when I put that fucking headset on, that's it. It's going back. That's not going to happen. Right now, I'm playing on my giant fucking screen, and it is dead steady. But my friend said that you feel more connected and that he was way faster time-wise with his VR2 headset. He bought a PSVR2 headset, even though against my recommendation, he bought it anyway. And said, well, I'm going to try it because what I'm hearing. And I showed him a couple of videos on YouTube of PSVR2 video. And he goes, oh, that's fucking bad. And I went, yeah, so why are you buying one? He says, I don't think it looks like that. So I guess I'm going to find out because I haven't tried out the PSVR 2 with Gran Turismo. I have tried some of the newer other headsets, but not PSVR 2 with Gran Turismo, which is a PSVR 2 game. If it sucks, I will be sending it back. This is why I bought it from Amazon. I got a great deal. Okay, it's $3.99 for the game and the headset. And then, of course, I had to buy the spacers for my glasses so that I didn't scratch the lenses. These lenses or the VR headset lenses, or I wouldn't be able to send it back. So I had to invest $20 in the protector. And then I'll let you know. Because you know me, you're going to get the real fucking deal from me. You're not going to, oh, Sony sent me this PSVR 2. Yeah, that's not going to happen. You know me. You're going to get the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. If it sucks, if it's janky and jerky like this, okay, I'm going to tell you, don't fucking buy this shit. Invest in a 150-inch AWOL vision projector, okay? That's what I've been telling people because all of my VR headset experience has been bad. Not real, not more immersive, just uncomfortable, heavy, hot, sweaty. I mean, when I put my buddies headset on, he had already been playing. It was wet with sweat all the way around. I mean, just fucking nasty. Had to take a towel and try to dry it, and you know, the material they made it out of didn't reject the sweat the way it should have. Okay, it was just a nasty experience. Now the thing with VR, if I buy lenses to insert, I will, if I put on the headset and everything works good and it looks good and it's as advertised, then okay, I will enjoy it. Dirt Rally is a VR title, but not a PSVR 2 title. So that kind of fucks me there, okay? Because they're not interchangeable. VR games will not play on PSVR 2 games. You have to have a PS5 console, okay? So I'll be stuck playing Dirt Rally 1, which is the only VR version they came out with because it was basically a Sony collaboration game. I'll just have to live with it. Maybe they'll port it over. I doubt it after this much time. If they haven't done it, they're not going to do it. Everybody's saying that Borderlands 2 VR also is not cross-compatible with PlayStation 5, so maybe they'll port that over. I don't know. But there are not many fucking games. I am getting this exclusively for Gran Turismo 7. Exclusively, okay? If anything else is fun and enjoyable, hey, cool. You know what I mean? That's cool. That's just a plus benefit. But again, if it looks like what I'm seeing on every single one of these videos, go look. Any PSVR 2 video, Gran Turismo 7, and you look at what's going on. So it's like the guy is sitting there, just sitting, ready to start in a car, dead fucking stopped. And it's going, and I mean, he would literally have to be doing like that with his head. So I'm thinking that this headset's going to get here. That's what it's going to look like. And it will fucking be going back. Because I can tell you, when I'm 5 feet from that 150-inch projector, it takes up all of your peripheral vision. And you think you're there in the car. You literally think you're in the car. Okay? It's, as far as I'm concerned, nothing has come close to my gaming experience with my projector. I've been very, very, very happy with it, okay? No lag. I haven't had any problems with that. I never run my AWOL Vision projector. I never put it in turbo mode. I don't need turbo mode. I never notice any lag, okay? I want to tell you that. So I've had zero negative experiences with the setup I have right now, zero. So this is, again, this is why I bought it from Amazon, so that if I have to send it back, I can. Now, it asks you to select who you want to buy it from, and I selected Amazon, and it said that unit was no longer available. So it's going to take a month to fucking get here, and I hope that if I have to send it back, I don't get the fucking restocking scam where they charge you $150 to restock a $399 sale. Because this is why they have these great sales at Amazon. I want to warn you, okay? This is why they have the great fucking $399 for the game and the headset. It's because they want you to buy it, and then you get it, and something's missing, or it's fucking used, which I run into constantly at Amazon, okay? And when you send it back, then they want to fucking hit you with a giant restocking fee. And that is a scam I've done many videos about, okay? And it's getting worse. And I have this horrible sinking feeling that I just fucked myself. You know what I mean? So anyway, I'll let you know, okay? So that you don't make the mistake. I'll make it for you if it is a mistake. If it's fantastic, I'll tell you. If it sucks, I'll tell you. If it's mediocre, I'll tell you, okay? And you know, 100% without a fucking doubt, that what you're going to get from me is going to be the actual truth and nothing but the truth.